Hello and welcome back to Stonehearth, ladies and gentlemen. Today we are back in Pride Rock and we need to do some building. I currently have all of my footmen just doing miscellaneous things. Some are idle, some are eating, some are restocking. It's all good. Gonna get those guys back to work. If the thing here could stop being weird, that'd be great. There we go. Just gonna get those guys back to doing their thing and patrolling. We have 10 people in the red squad. We have 25 hearthlings, and as you can see, the wall is finished with a bunch of lights around it as well. Some of them are fancy lights. For some reason, this one hasn't been removed, even though it should be. Hopefully, someone's going to get to that eventually. Yeah, plenty of lights around the wall. I did have some archers up there. I don't anymore. But what I'd like to do is I'd like to go to my blacksmith, and I would like my blacksmith to craft me the decorative scout gong. And we are going to hope for the best, is what we're going to do, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to hope for the best. Placing this thing is, as far as I can tell, pretty much a sign of war. So this could go well, this could go terribly, who knows, who knows. Let's go ahead and send my warriors out this way just a little bit. I'm also pretty sure I want to get a third archer. I'm going to take my kind of weakest footman in terms of body. So you are going to become an archer. Or you were going to. I don't think my carpenter has actually finished the job I set them, which was to, make a bunch of those and then make that. We don't actually have the leather for it, which is curious. Hopefully we can get that kind of soon. I imagine my weaver might be doing a lot of work at the moment, so that's no big deal. You guys are all heading out to attack the giant stone golem, which really, yeah, that was no problem at all. There we go. Okay, blacksmiths, what are you guys up to? You are working on that, okay. I'm aware of the fact that placing this thing is a sign of war. I'm a little bit nervous about this, but it's good. We're moving forward, and that's what's important. We need to win this war, and when we win this war, that is Pride Rock. That's Pride Rock accomplished and ready to live the rest of their lives doing whatever they want to do. I really wish... Are my blacksmiths by any chance, like, sleeping at the moment? No, they don't seem to be. All right, I'm not seeing them up there, so I don't really know what they're doing. Who are you all? What are you guys doing? That's my engineer. My engineer hasn't done anything in a while. My potter's not really doing anything. I guess I could give my engineer some work. You're still an apprentice, though. That's the problem. I kind of need you to be higher level before I can give you work to do. I guess you can craft a bunch of bronze gears, though. So craft, like, 20 of those, and that'll be your job for a while. As the blacksmith, I'm going to assume that we've got the gong finished. We do. All right. This is big. This is important. This is a very important step in the history of Pride Rock. The moment this gong gets placed, which I think can go there, to be honest. I think that's a nice spot for it. So we're going to place that. And then whatever happens, happens. Oh boy, this is good. This is big. This is big news. But I'm all right with it. Let's see. What's everybody up to? Is anyone... Oh, someone's going to place it. Who's got the gong? Someone's heading over to place it. Oh, you. Okay, maybe not. You were gonna, but you're like, you know what? Maybe before I declare war, I'll go to bed. That is a very smart thing to do. Going to bed before you declare war. That's very... Oh, no, someone's placing it. You. Qui passu. Or Qui. Hold on, let's rename you. Your name, I can't pronounce your name, all right? So I'm gonna, you are now Keith. You are just Keith. There you go. So Keith is, heading.
All right, I'm Keith. I'm just gonna place a gong just right here. There we go. No bother. You're welcome.
So Keith, you have declared war, I think, what this means. Interesting. Yeah. A kobold stares longingly at your piles of gold.
Oh, shinies, gong, emerald. We see you many treasures in the piles and boxes. Us need many, many loots. You share, yes?
Yes, well, I don't, Yeah, you can try and take it. You can try and take my riches, but I'm going to come out there and attack you. And I'm assuming you are the biggin. So, or are you all named? No, you're all named. Interesting. You're a knight. You are... There's some workers out there. What is this? Is that the only enemy camp? It seems to be. All right. I've got no problem going out and attacking you, all you. Let's make it so. Let's go. Let's attack that guy and be done with this. We are going to take the battle to them. That's how this is going to work. I'm also going to just grab my soldiers and have them sort of regroup. So let's head over and let's start by attacking that guy instead. I don't know who you are, but you're going to die. Here's what you're going to do. Ooh, they're a little bit tough, but I think we'll be all right. Hold on a minute. Let's have a look at... So those are the enemies. Daily update. We have the food. We have the morale. We don't have the net worth. No big deal. Let's kill that guy. Who is proving to be tough. Maybe focus on the archers first. Let's take out the archers so that we're not taking damage from all sides. The kobold scout whimpers on the ground. Interesting.
Us too weak. Put out a lead gong if you dare.
Interesting. So we can bring an even bigger fight. I thought that would be the end of it. I thought that would bring a huge battle, but I mean, we're kind of having no problems here. Like, honestly speaking, like there's not really all that many. There's not much of a challenge at the moment, is what I'm realizing. So, I mean, in a way, that's good. I was worried that a huge army would barrel down on me and kill everybody, but apparently not. So that's a thing. That's a view. Now, Carpenter level 5 is big news. Because Carpenter level 5 means I can get the Shepherd's Crook, which means I can get a couple of farms going. So what does a blacksmith need to make this elite gong? We need an elite kobold hat. Question. Did one get dropped? Yes, it did. I would like to go and loot that. I would really like someone to go and loot that. But I don't know if that's a thing that is going to happen. There's actually a couple of kobold hats by there. We haven't currently got that one in our possession. But I'm going to queue this order anyway. I'm going to queue one of them. And we'll put it as a top priority order. And maybe that'll encourage my blacksmiths to come out and grab this hat. Which I'd really like them to do. And I imagine since we're making this from an elite kobold hat, that's got to count for something, right? I don't think there's anything I can really sell here. There's a few pelts, I suppose. I might as well sell those. There we go. Yeah, it doesn't look like we're grabbing this at all. There is, admittedly, a lot of stuff that we still need to loot. But I kind of don't want to. What is that? A master's bling hat. Interesting. I wonder if that's something I'm going to need to make a gong from at some point as well. That is very interesting. I assume my blacksmiths aren't actually working on... No, they're not. How do I encourage my hearthlings to go out and grab this? Because I've been reading up on the looting thing. Because whilst this wall was getting built, you know, we've got loot up here. We had loot all over the map. I had to clear the loot orders in order to sort of get anything else really done. Like, they're not really doing any looting. They're going out and grabbing wood, which is a thing that they need, but they're just not looting. So I don't know. It seems really, really strange. Maybe if I clear the order for a second, just like that. And then I say, go and loot that very specifically. That might help. Doesn't seem to be. Doesn't seem to be helping at all. Which is really disappointing because I need to grab that. I want this battle. I want the battle to come to me. Because I'd really like to win. Because winning is apparently all we do here at Pride Rock. And that goblin wolf seems to be coming straight for us. Does the game tell you, like if you hover over this? Oh, it does. So what's taking up the most of the processing? Whatever this is. The lure. All right. So there's a few... Yeah, so you can actually see what the... I think you can see what the processes are. Okay. Fair enough. Oh, hello. You're a couple of biggins. Let's maybe send my army out to deal with you. Oh, that's going to be no problem. Let's go. Come on, armed forces. Let's deal with these invaders, of which there are a few, but it's nothing I can't deal with. Come on, get them killed. Oh, wow, this frame rate thing. The game really is starting to struggle a little bit. Which is a shame, because I really want to see these future battles. I want to see us win. I just really don't want to see it in what's... It says 60 FPS on my screen, but... it's an early access game. What can I say? They you know, it's not finished. It's not fully optimized. And the game isn't necessarily supposed to support over 20 Hearthlings. So in a way, it's kind of to be expected. Are you... I didn't notice you. All right, let's go kill you then. You look like you're wearing an elite hat as well. So maybe we'll get your hat as opposed to the one that dropped earlier. I guess that's a thing I can maybe look forward to. If you would do me the honor of dying. There you go. No, you didn't drop a hat. That's fine. There is another one, isn't there? Oh, no, he's dead. All right, so we still haven't grabbed the hat. And I have a sneaking suspicion we're maybe not going to, which is annoying. Which is really, really annoying. So I've done a little bit more reading into this looting issue. And I'm going to have my carpenter go ahead and make me a large crate. And once that's done, I'm going to put that large crate over here. And people have been saying on some forums from a while ago, admittedly, but they've been saying nonetheless that putting crates or storage in general close to the things that you want looted will sometimes make it work. So we're going to see if this works. Hopefully it will. I can't imagine it's made already. No, it isn't, but that's no big deal. We do have some silkweed seeds and some acorns as well, so I'm going to plop those just out there so we can go and learn those particular recipes. And whilst that's all going on as well, what I'd like to do is, I guess, get some farming areas out here, because we might as well at this point. We have all the space to play with. So, let's do that, and it can be turnips. And we'll just do a big old space for some turnips to grow. We have a simple merchant there. I'm not all that interested in your wares, buddy. I'm kind of fine with what I've got going on in here. I have all these turnips, I've got all my carrots, I've just got everything I'm ever going to need, and I don't really need your wares. I also realize I am going ahead and... Hold on, can that go there? No. I also realize I'm leaving gaps here when I really don't need to, but I think it might just look a bit nicer if I leave the gaps, to be honest. So we'll do this kind of thing with a bunch of turnips up this way. Like so. I'd also like to go that way as well. And up to it there as well. Just going to make a little pattern with my turnip growing. And it's going to be beautiful, is what it's going to be. I do need to get rid of that particular bit, though. Then go in here with a few more sections of farmland. Like so. To there. Turnip. To there. Turnip. And then this last little bit as well can just be a bunch of turnips too. And hopefully we can actually maintain this. We might need more farmers, but I'm gonna say that we might also not. So there we go. That's gonna be a new space for turnips to grow down there. Simple merchant, I don't really care for your wares, sir. So you can get lost, buddy. And in terms of storage, we still don't have anything. So that's no big deal. Let's learn these, which is great news. Looks like my farmers are going to be heading down that way to sort this space out. I don't think I'm actually growing any turnips at the moment, so fair enough. Fair enough. We can start growing them down here, and it should be good. As for everything else that's going on, have we got storage yet? No. We also have a lot of trees. I should sell those. I really should. There it is. All right. So let's place this just in that spot. Hopefully someone's going to head out and do that. I'm hearing... Ah, hello. This thing's been here this whole time and I haven't done anything about it, isn't it? Or hasn't it? I swear I can speak. Hopefully someone's going to head out and place that chest. There we go. Someone's doing it. My warriors are heading out to deal with this. That's going to be no problem at all. You've got the crate. And I'm sincerely hoping this works. I want this to work. Because if this works, then we can bring on whatever's after, you know, whatever comes next. Oh, you're doing it, aren't you? You are looting. You are looting. Are you going to grab that? Oh my god. Oh my god. They did it. It worked. That was legitimately a method to get that to work. We can get the decorative elite gong. Whatever's next, we can fight it. And that's good, because I really want to. We have some goblins up there that I'm not too worried about, because there's not that many of them. So what I'll do is, for one, I am going to promote you to be an archer. Just like so. And three archers is probably all I'm going to need. Oh, they're doing a fair bit of looting out there, actually. That's really good news, actually. That really is. So that's the problem. Basically, if there's not storage nearby, they're not going to do it. Unless all my storage elsewhere is full, but I really doubt it. I really doubt this is full. So that's full. Full. It's not all full, is it? Have I filled all my storage? You are joking. So that's the... That explains a lot. That explains an awful lot. Okay. Well, we don't currently have a mason. So I'm going to get my carpenter to make me a bunch of crates. I mean, we could do a bunch of leather-bound chests, but... We'll just do a bunch of crates. And I'll get, like, 63 of them. And that should be fine. 63 crates means I can plop them all in there and we'll have a bunch of storage. And I think I feel like a bit of an idiot, to be honest. Oh boy, I feel like a bit of an idiot. It's no big deal. It's sorted. It's out of the way. It's done. It's dusted. We fixed the problem. To be honest, it's a problem that really shouldn't have been a problem. But it's fine. We'll just not worry about it. We'll just not worry about it. And we'll move on. So hopefully we're going to see my blacksmiths get this new gong finished quickly. I think they're currently working on it. I think. Unless you are the blacksmith bringing that hat back, but it doesn't look like it. Daily update. We are so close to getting the net worth for another person. We also didn't really have the food there. But I reckon we'll get the food. And I reckon while I'm waiting... Oh, invaders approaching. Where? Interesting. All right, let's send my warriors out to deal with this. What on earth is this? What is this? Is this two groups of invaders? Hold on, I want to watch this. Are they going to fight? It looks like they're going to fight. Or are they regrouping? Oh, they're regrouping. Okay, that's... I really should have attacked them while I had the chance, but whatever. That's that sorted. Let's, have this fight then. We have my three archers providing ranged cover, which is exactly what we want. We actually have, what are you? What is that hat? You are, I don't know what you are. I mean, you're going to be dead is what you're going to be, but I don't know what you are right now. Which is particular. Are you wearing blue? Oh, look at you in your different outfit. Is that like the apprentice archer thing? Or is that... I've never seen an archer wearing blue. I just thought they all wore green. But apparently I was wrong. Let's select this group, I guess, and focus on the big guy. Then focus on this guy. And hopefully get him out of here nice and quickly, because he looks like he's dealing a fair bit of damage. Oh yeah, he is, he's not having a great time there. Then we'll get you. And I don't think I need to micromanage them anymore. I think they're probably all right. As for the gong, has it been crafted? Yes, it has. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. All right, there it is. The Elite Gong. It's going to go, I guess, on this side. I guess. Not really anywhere else I can put it. So I'll put it there. And someone can get to placing that, at which point I'm assuming some kobold is going to be super upset with me. But it's going to be totally worth it. Oh, I'm excited. I'm legitimately so excited. I want to see what this fight's going to be. And I want to see if we can survive. I mean, every fight that the game has thrown my way thus far, we have passed with flying colors. There's been no problem that we couldn't deal with. So, I'm hoping that this fight will go the same way. No guarantees, obviously. But I'm hoping. Now that's you going down to place the gong with the looks of it. Dangerous goblin nearby. Alright, let's maybe go and deal with the dangerous goblin first before we go and deal with the cursed church there. Just get them out of here. Are they both dead? No, they're not. There we go. Kill those goblins as well, then kill the camp, and then maybe go kill the church as well. Come on. Oh my god, that frame, it's not even frame rate. I don't know what to call it. That's the worst thing. It's like, oh, that frame rate. It's not frame rate though. Some familiar looking goblins begin building huts near your town. Okay. What was his voice? I mean, if we're gonna go with my usual type of voice for characters, then I guess, you recognize. No, that wasn't it. No, me don't know you. You saying us all look same? No, we busy. So we ignore and go back to setting up camp. Why? We're contractors. We make camp. Orc bias. Those orc obsessed with honor. Politics. New Khan. Soon enough, they send orc army here. And we need to clean up again. I see. The goblin's beady little eyes light up. No, me think a great idea. You pay us instead, and we make so no orc come. You just need to give us a few treasures. You win, me win, both win. Nah, I'm good. You know I want pay. Alright. Make a little difference for us. Watch for orc army. The army comes soon. There we go. I swear I can speak. Right. So basically, there is a goblin camp being set up, or there is a camp being set up somewhere, and there is an orc army coming my way at some point in the not too distant future. That is, I mean, that's not good, but thus far, again, everything the game has thrown at me has been a walk in the park. So I really don't know if I'm scared. I really don't know if I even care. You know? I'm gonna win. I know we're gonna win. We're Pride Rock. It's no problem. Well, this certainly looks like a camp. But these don't look like orcs. They look like goblins. So I'm assuming they are maybe the contractors, or maybe that's just a random goblin camp that spawned, but I'm not seeing anything else. So we're going to go and attack, is what we're going to do. We're going to move all my units over here right away. Get them out there and get them ready for battle. And then once they're grouped together, we can go and, you know, try and take out this camp, which seems like a particularly good idea. So, let's get them battle ready. Looks like, we've got one guy that's very keen, and then the rest of the group sort of lagging behind. So if we move them to there, and then, send them into attack. Oh, hold up a minute. So this is the group that I really want to be dealing with. No problem. No problem at all. If my clerics could keep everyone alive, then it's even less of a problem, but it looks like we're dealing with this without too much hassle. Let's maybe focus on this guy who is doing a lot of damage. Daily update, what have we got? We have the food, we have everything. We are getting a 26th hearthling. Good timing. We're in the middle of battle. Hopefully we can kill these guys. That one's running away. That's fine. Let's kill this one. Let's kill these little guys. Oh my god. The lag though. I just wanna not lag. It's all I wanna do. I just wanna win the battle and see it in a glorious 60 FPS that's actually 60 FPS and not 60 FPS, but not actually that in the game. Can you see my problem? I also realize this might be a completely separate camp to the one over there. This might not even be the camp I was really looking for. Which is kind of annoying, actually. Kill this thing. Kill that wolf. And then kill this guy. Oh, this micromanaging, though. There is a lot of micromanagement to be done here. Seriously, let's focus on you. And get you out of the way. I will say, having these three archers is proving to be so useful. Really is. Let's get you as well. There we go. Then take out the building. There we go. Then take out the rest of them. Invaders approaching. Where? Oh, it's just this group. Okay, no problem. Oh, slightly worried that there was an attack coming in from some other direction, but nope. We are fine. Also, looks like we are doing okay here. No one seems to be dying, which is great. The little goblins are taking a lot of damage and aren't really much of an issue either. The blacksmith has unlocked the decorative master gong recipe. Is that so? Is that so? Huh. Funny that. I can see the hat right there. I mean, I guess we'll have to get another crate out here, won't we? And then we'll have to get the other gong. And then we're gonna have to hope for the best. I mean, the master one seems like it would be sort of top level. I don't know what would come after that. I mean, there was... No, I think, because that's the guy we saw, wasn't it? We saw one with, like, the pink, and he was a master. Oh, boy. So what would we do? I mean, if I set that to be looted, and then I maybe suggest we put a crate out here. We'll do a fine crate like that. Get rid of all of that. There we go. So, we need to make the master gong, which is this one. We don't currently have the hat for it, but we'll get it. So we'll just chuck that up there. And we're going to bring another army to Pride Rock to see if they can possibly defeat us. But what I will say is that win or lose, for a multitude of reasons, ladies and gentlemen, specifically two, this battle, like I said, win or lose, is going to be the last battle with Pride Rock. The Master's Gong is ready to place. So let's, I guess, chuck it over here next to all the other ones. And we're going to see what they send. Oh my god. It's weird playing Stonehearth this way because I've always played it as a game. Hold on. Is that even... That's in a different spot. That's going to be annoying. It is weird playing Stonehearth this way because I've always played it in a very sort of relaxed and just... I guess I play it with the builder's mindset. I don't play it with like the adventurer's combat mindset. But I'm really enjoying this. I'm really enjoying this. It's so much fun to sort of give myself this particular challenge of, you know, actually winning things, I guess. So there we go. That's that now placed. That's three different gongs. An ogre stomps into town.
Puny town. You Mount Mark of Ruby. You dare challenge me, Chief Groot Bashbrain.
You don't scare me.
Your precious Cid Treaty can't protect you now, you foolish humans.
So, what does that mean? What exactly is this ogre planning? Daily update. All right. I thought that was going to be war, but it isn't. Oh, there they are.
So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ogres. No, it's not. No, it's not. 6, 7, 8, 9 ogres. As well as a large totem. And quite a few of those guys too. That looks like it might be a slightly different hat. But I feel like it might be time to send out my army to attack this particular ogre. And I guess we're going to have to hope for the best. We got this. Like, this isn't going to be a problem at all. I'm not worried about this attack. Because ogres aren't that hard to kill. Now, they do have a little bit of backup over there, but that's no big deal either. Oh, we are taking a lot of damage, actually. Let's maybe focus on this one. We'll just keep up the micromanagement, and then it's going to be no problem. Ah, no, that one's dying. He's dead. Take out that one. Come on, focus. Focus. As long as the archers are focusing, it's no problem. There we go. Take out that one. He's pretty low on health as well. Come on, archers. Come on, archers. Right, that's fine. Take out this one. He's quite low on health. Oh my god, we're doing this. We're actually doing this. Take out that one as well. All right, no problem. Then take out this guy. And then we're good. Then the first wave has been beaten. Invaders are oh no. Oh no. I don't think I was ready for this. I don't think this is going to be something I'm necessarily going to survive. Hold up, hold up, hold up. You know what we need? We need more warriors. I need people with, like, you. You're going to be a warrior. You'll be a footman. Congratulations on your promotion, buddy. Keith. No, you're good. You're good. Keith's good. You are also going to become a footman. So that's hopefully going to help us. It's risky putting some level 1 footmen on the field against all of this. But with these being some pretty intense enemies that we're going up against, I imagine they might level really quickly. At least that's my hope and that's my thinking. All right, now that they're dead, these guys are attacking from that side. That's a problem. Oh, that's a problem. Okay. Let's kill you and hope that my guys can be healed before then. We do have this group back here, but I'm not worried about them. They seem to be fairly stationary. So if we can kill this group, we're fine. And there's not as many ogres there. There's only 2 and then a bunch of archers. That's my concern. Stop attacking my people. Those were footmen. Those were the new footmen. I'm an idiot. I sent the new footmen to their deaths. Oh, I can't believe that. No! The Mani Rib is getting wrecked there. Taking a bit of health there from the clerics. That's beautiful news. Come on, buddy. Oh, stay alive. Stay alive. That's all I need to... Uh-oh. Right, you're low. You are real low. Kill that archer. Right, after this particular attack, we need them to rest up for a little bit. I don't know if that's actually going to be a thing we can do, because this lot might attack as soon as this lot's dead. But I'm sincerely hoping that we're going to have time to rest. All I need is time for my clerics to heal them. That's all I need them to do. I can't believe I lost these two. I can't believe I sent them to their deaths. I feel terrible. I feel so bad. I straight up sent them to their deaths. That was completely on me. Oh my god. I can't believe that. That was such a stupid move. That was such an amateur move. Okay. It's fine. It's fine. It's an issue. It shouldn't have happened, but it's fine. We can deal with it, and we can move on from it. Let's see, anything interesting lying around up here? Not really. There's another one of those hats. That is a master's bling hat. You guys are all sort of needing to eat at the moment. So if you could all go and eat, and then I'll send you out to attack this camp. I'm hoping that this camp is the last of it. Oh, bother! They attacked! Or did they? No. No, they didn't. Something, or, well, clearly they, broke through the door. Which is alarming, but we do have more health than we did last time. So I'm hoping we're going to be all right here. Let's take out this archer. Let's take out these guys. Take out that one very specifically, please. Come on. Take out you. Let's just kill them. Let's get them right. Oh, my clerics are back there, aren't they? Those are my clerics. Right. Move. Get into the base. Let them break the doors. Just keep the clerics nearby. But the one that's in here, focus on him. And kill him. Then, for the other lot, they had to run around. This is actually a really good situation we're in here. Because if I need to retreat, all I need to do is go through the door. And they won't break this one down. They'll go through that one. So this is actually, watch this. If I go through here, they'll just run away. And that's what I want them to do. Because that gives me a chance to heal. And gives me a chance to sort of stay safe. Which is super important. So, let's go kill this guy. Nice and quickly. And kill this guy. Okay, I might be gaming the game a little bit here. But as strategies go, I'm more than happy to cheat that one. Let's see, anything interesting here? Yeah, we're going to be getting a few people, aren't we? Sure. Alright. So once this guy's dead, we're kind of doing okay. I'm gonna have to go out here and kill them. I'm gonna have to go to them. Oh boy. Oh boy. Alright. Go focus this one. I wanna kill this one. And hope for the best. We need to do this. We need to kill them. Kill that one. Oh boy. We're gonna take a lot of damage here. We're gonna take a lot of damage here. Kill him. Kill him. Right, then kill this one. Just focus on specific ones. As long as we're micromanaging this attack, we are okay. The Ogre Chief shakes his fist angrily.
Don't get arrogant, puny humans. Brethren from Capital are where to test their might. Any town bearing the General's gong will not be unheeded.
There's another one. But I said that that would be the last one. Oh, but now I need to fight that one. So this isn't going to be the final episode? I thought that would be the last one. Oh my god. So that kind of makes me think that maybe... Now that's bad. That's very bad. I'm going to lose all my people. Oh dear. Oh god. Oh god. No. Run. Get back to the base. Get back to the base right now. Get back to the base. Everyone needs to go out and... Oh my god, there's ogres. There's... What is happening down there? I don't know that I want to look. Oh my god, this is bad. This is so bad. Come on! Survive, damn it! They can't get through the door! Oh, Jesus. I think we'll be alright. A dangerous goblin. I don't care! There's more dangers in the base right now because we don't have a sodding door! Are we alright? No, we're not. What is this? Right, let's kill that guy. Kill him. Just get him dead. Oh, and then we need to make the master's gong. And that, I'm assuming, is probably the final fight. It has to be, right? It can't not be. I don't know what it's made out of, but I'm assuming it's going to be like the final fight. Are you guys done up there? Looks like it. All right. Let's head out. We have more fighting to do. Oh my god. Kill that goblin. Just finish him off and be done with it, please. Just wreck this camp. That's all I need you to do. Wreck the camp. Kill the goblins. Kill the archers. Just please finish them off. That's all I want at this point. So he's dead. Or he's going to be. There we go. Kill the kobold. And that's got to be it, right? What is this? Master's bling hat. That's a lot of them. Okay. So what is this made out of? The general... one of those. The general's hat. Is there a general's hat there? Of course there is. All right. Okay. I'll do it. I'll place a box. We're gonna summon whatever we're gonna summon. I don't know. This could be big. Oh my god. It's time to place the general's golden gong. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know what's going to come about because of this, but I'm definitely excited to see if this is maybe the final battle. Because it could be. It could very well be the final battle. And that would be some pretty big news if it was, but I'm excited to find out. Definitely excited to find out. What I'm also going to do is go ahead and start placing a bunch of these down. Because we, hold up, we will deal with the troop of orcs in just a second. I want to just place a bunch of these crates so that we have some storage in there. That one placed a bit weirdly. No worries, we'll fix that in a little bit. What do we got?
So long it's been since we have seen the purple glimmer of a general's token. The Red Kiln would stand to benefit from fighting more foes such as yourself.
Thank you.
That being said, we too are not to be underestimated. We have fought more beasts and creatures than your settlement could ever conceive. I look forward to our fight.
Is that so? Invaders approaching. Wow. They are immediately attacking. And interestingly, I'm not seeing anything in there that I haven't seen before. I'm seeing the loot chest and all that, but I'm not seeing any hats that I haven't once seen before. So, this could be the final fight, which will be pretty big news. So let's go ahead and send my warriors forward. If we fix that door, we have not. Right, we need to get everybody back. Everybody needs to... I'm going to lose people. Yeah. I'm going to lose a few people here. That's fine. It's not, but it's going to have to be okay because there's nothing I can do about it. Let's kill these little guys as quick as we possibly can. Because the big guys are coming through the door any second. There they are. All right. Focus on the big guys. They don't have clerics, do they? Difficult to see. I need to pull back. We need to run away. Do they have clerics? Yes. Yes, they do. Okay. Kill this guy. Then kill that cleric. As long as we can kill the cleric, then they can't heal. And we kind of need them to not be able to heal. Kill this guy. Do they have any more clerics? That's the real question. You might be one. I don't think you are, though. So that's no big deal. Focus on this guy. No, you know what? They don't have any more clerics. Which means this is going to be a fairly simple fight. Invaders approaching. No big deal. Kill these guys. Nice and quickly does it. Oh, they have reinforcements. They have quite a few reinforcements, actually. Interesting. Go kill that one. Pull them through the base. Pull them through the choke point. Let's retreat to this position over here. In fact, let's retreat out here. Let's go out that door and force them to go around. Come on, my knight is getting wrecked. Jesus, get out there. Go. Right. So stay there, heal the knight. Heal. All right, then attack. Okay. This micromanagement is getting intense. Kill the biggin. Quite a few guys over there that we need to deal with at some point. We could kill that guy. I'm tempted to say we just push back through the base and draw them around, which I think is going to be a fairly smart thing to do. As for the attack order, it's going to be to kill these guys as quick as we possibly can, please. Manny Rib is severely low on health. That's bad. That's very bad. Who is Manny Rib, though? Kill this guy. See, this is mostly an issue because they just have... Because they have so many archers. That's the problem. That daily update is absolutely going to give me a hearthling. Kill you. Hold on a minute. Is that one I've seen before? I'm pretty sure I've seen the red one before. Okay, are we done here? Nearly. Yeah, we're totally nearly done here. Look at this. Take that building out. An enemy approaches. No problem. Take out the big guy. They have a cleric. Kill the cleric. Kill that cleric. Take out the biggin. And then take out this guy. Actually, no, the biggin's still alive. Right, he's gone. Take out this guy. Have we done this? Have we legitimately done this? I can turn off alert mode. I don't think I need to worry about my hearthlings coming out at this point. I mean, they will, but they're not going to be the ones that get attacked. Kill this guy. Because he's still doing some significant damage to us. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Okay. That was unexpected. That's bad. I lost an archer. I've lost another archer. I'm about to lose another one. Oh, the game did not just do that. My clerics are still alive. But without archers, I don't think I can win this. Especially since I'm pretty sure they have clerics. It's difficult. I think you're a cleric, right? Yeah, you are. You need to die. There we go. Now take out that big guy. Come on, we can win this without archers. We can win this without archers. I can't believe the game just did that to me. Take out the camp. So that might stop them spawning. What else have we got? Take out this guy. I'm honestly kind of mad. I'll be honest. That's kind of crappy. What the game just did there. Oh my god. No. Rest in peace. Rip Pride Rock. There's no way we're winning now. Nope. There we go. Nope. I can't believe it. I cannot believe the game actually did that to me. I honestly cannot believe the game actually did that to me. That's That's infuriating. We killed the orc, apparently. What? Given us the period of political... But matters that the War Chief will wish to meet you again for now. The War Chief's not going to meet me again. I have nothing left to fight with. Everyone's dead. They're going to go attack that, but what have I got left? I've got nothing. I cannot believe it spawned them on my troops. Ladies and gentlemen, Pride Rock, it's not necessarily fallen, but we lost over 10 people. We lost my entire armed forces. I don't think could build back from that. Because these guys are going to be so tough to fight that regular footmen wouldn't be able to survive. So we would just lose the battle and just lose more hearthlings. So, ladies and gentlemen, Pride Rock has been defeated not by the armies of the Red Kiln, but by Stonehearth itself. And I don't want this to be the outcome of this series, because we were doing so well. But hopefully you can understand that after some bullshit like that, I don't really want to play Stonehearth for a little while. So I'm going to leave it there for today, and I'm going to leave it there for Stonehearth for a couple of weeks, or maybe until the next update or two comes out. And hopefully by then, I'll not have that happen to me. Thank you, Ken, for watching. This has been Stonehearth Season 2. It's been Pride Rock. I am proud of what we built. I'm not proud of that outcome, and I'm not happy about that outcome. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.